We begin our sermon today with a song. Harper Rodriguez is going to sing for us A Place in This World. Harper?
I don't know what I want, so don't ask me, cause I'm sitting on trying to figure it out. Don't know what's down this road. I'm just walking, trying to see through the rain coming down. You know I'm not the only one who feels the way I do. I'm alone on my own, and that's all I know. I'll be strong, I'll be wrong, oh, but life goes on. Oh, I'm just a girl trying to find a place in this world. Got the radio on, my old blue jeans, and I'm wearing my heart on my sleeve, feeling lucky today. Got the sunshine, could you tell me what more do I need? And tomorrow's just a mystery, oh yeah, but that's okay. I'm alone on my own, and that's all I know. I'll be strong, I'll be wrong, oh, but life goes on. Oh, I'm just a girl trying to find a place in this world. Maybe I'm just a girl on a mission that I'm ready to fly. I'm in love on my own, and that's all I know. Oh, I'll be strong, I'll be wrong, oh, but life goes on. Oh, I'm in love on my own, and that's all I know. Oh, trying to find a place in this world.
Thank you, Harper. That was beautiful. And thank you for bringing us those prophetic words from Taylor Swift. Did you catch the lyrics there? I'm alone on my own. It's all I know. I'll be strong. I'll be wrong. Oh, but life goes on. I'm just a girl trying to find a place in this world. Well, aren't we all? Aren't we all right now struggling to find our place in this world that looks so unfamiliar to us? This world that has changed in ways we never imagined. There is so much going on around us that we don't even understand. And so we are struggling to find our place in this world of today. And even as a country, we start to open up and reopen a little bit. There are those who are still in quarantine. You know, remember in the days when we used to fly on airplanes? Remember those days? And when it got to cruising altitude, the stewardess would say, "You are now free to move about the cabin." Well, it's as if someone is saying, "You are now free to move about the country, except if you're at high risk." And if you're at high risk, if you're older, if you've got some other health issue that would put you at high risk, you stay in. You're probably going to be in until there's a vaccine. So we still have people who are isolated and alone in the midst of everything that's going on. Chris Hanstrom told me last week that other than the drive-in person at the pharmacy at Walgreens, she has not been in the presence of another human being for more than 3 months. Now, it's hard not to feel isolated when you haven't been around people for 3 months and still going. And compare that to Anne Brown, my friend Anne Brown, who's in healthcare. Her job never skipped a beat. And so she's been scurrying about it, but in the midst of this, she is scurrying about in a community that is on pause. and with people that she knows who are high risk, who are still in quarantine. Anne said to me, you know, Myra, it's surreal. It is surreal. In the midst of all of this, we have an economy that is spiraling downward. And we have businesses who are saying they are not going to be financially able to reopen. We have restaurants. Some of our favorite restaurants are not going to be able to reopen. We have food banks stretched to their max. More people are taking food than we've ever seen in this country before. And we have unprecedented numbers of unemployment. And yet, in the midst of all of that, we have this COVID-19 money flowing through, right? Many of us got stimulus checks. And businesses got loans. And there's some added benefit to your unemployment check, for at least for the next couple of months. So I'm not saying, listen, don't get me wrong. That's a great thing, and I'm so glad our government reacted this way. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with this. I'm just commenting on the paradox of it all. The craziness of this world and what makes it so hard to understand. You know, in many ways, our series this month has been about trying to find our place in the world. Finding that place, right? Making a joyful noise, and we talked about the noise being a connectional noise, that we find our place in the world through connection, through joyful connection. It's a noise that is for what is right and for what is good. We find our place in the world, and that last week we talked about service, right? We find our place in the world through service, serving others, but also serving in truth. We've been talking about finding our place in the world. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Well, we're going to pause right here today. We're going to pause right at we are his people. What does it mean to be God's people? Because I think if we're going to find our place in the world, we have to understand exactly who we are and whose we are. Take a second look at those verses out of the New Testament that James read a few minutes ago. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now, and what will be has not yet been revealed. Maybe God is reminding us that in order to find our place in the world, we do, in fact, need to remember that we belong to God. And we need to really look at who we are as the children of God. We are the children of God, but I have been drawn to that second verse. Did you catch this one? We are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. Listen to how Eugene Peterson translates that in the Message Bible. Friends, that's exactly who we are, children of God, and that's only the beginning. Who knows where we'll end up? Maybe this place in the world that we are so desperately seeking is not a finite thing. Maybe it's changing. Maybe our place in the world moves and changes because the world around us is certainly moving and changing. Just maybe our place in the world is the place where the world needs us the most. The great quote from Frederick Buechner. The place God calls you to is the place where your deep gladness meets the world's deep hunger. Your passion meets need, and that's your place. We have been focused on racial justice for the past couple of weeks, and rightfully so. Many of us joined the Black Lives Matter protest, and Pastor James led a group who wrote a racial justice statement for our church. It's beautiful. It's on our website. Please take a moment and read it all the way through. I'm going to read you just a portion of it. We are a body of believers acknowledging that the call to be the kingdom on earth as it is in heaven is a call to being an unconditionally loving and radically inclusive church of all humanity that stands at the forefront of racial injustice in our community and in our world. Just as Jesus Christ saw the humanity of those that were crucified on the cross with him, as well as those who placed him there, we see the humanity of all God's creation. Amen. Now there's our place in the world. There is our place. That right there, there is our place, standing on the side of racial justice, fighting for equality. There's a place in the world we can be proud of. But that's not the only place in the world for us as a congregation and as children of God. No, thank you, Mary Lou Graber, for reminding me the plight of the Native Americans in this country. The Native Americans who suffered massive and cruel injustice for decades, hundreds of years. That's Mary Lou's passion. And Mary Lou, you stand tall because that's your place in the world, or at least it's one of them. And of course, I can never forget about our friends in the LGBTQ community. Our Joyful Noise Month is also Pride Month, and we can't let that go past. I'm proud that we have been a church, well, who owns inclusion with our actions and our words. And we've had some things to celebrate this past week, right? Let's make a joyful noise for that landmark ruling from the Supreme Court. The court ruled that LGBTQ workers are protected against discrimination. Yes, that ruling lifted my heart. But it also makes me wonder why that would ever be in question, and why we need the highest court in the land to remind us of what is right. But we do, and the court did, and we'll be grateful. Our new radical justice statement sits alongside our diversity and inclusion statement. These are active groups in our church. Both are on the website. I think it's on that homepage. There's a pop-up down at the bottom. Again, I encourage you to go read both of these statements. They're beautifully done. Here's a portion of our diversity and inclusion statement. As an open, inclusive, and affirming congregation, we believe in the inherent dignity and worth of all people as children of God. And we seek to exemplify Jesus' example of love without reservation or exception. We welcome and celebrate diversity and the full inclusion of all people, regardless of age, race, culture, sexual orientation, gender identity expression, family configuration, physical ability, citizenship, language, or socioeconomic status. This is our place in the world. This is where we stand in the world. Again, standing with those who have been hurt, who have been marginalized because of who they are or who they love, that's our place. That's where the children of God gather. That's where we stand. And I know sometimes we feel torn. Is it this one or is it that one? I will tell you, a few years back, I was headed to Africa on a mission trip. And I went into a group, and one of the women there said, "Why do you do that, Myra? Why do you go all the way to Africa when there is so much need right here at home? Why do you have to go across the world?" And my answer to that is, it's not either or. It's both and. God expects us to do both and, or actually all and. And the good thing about it is that each of us is equipped with different skills. Each of us comes to this to find our own place where our passion meets the need of the world. That's our place in the world, and it will be different places for each of us. And frankly, it will be different places for us at different times. The one consistent thing that we will see is that all of these things are fighting for what is right and for what is good. We are fighting for that place in the world wherever we are needed. It is wherever there is hunger, wherever there is homelessness, wherever our brothers and sisters in the universal family of God are hurt and treated unfairly. That's our place. Yours and mine, that's our place in this world. Are we still trying to find our place in the world? Find our passion. Let's find our passion and go out and match that with the needs of the world. And then let's be prepared to, oh yeah, we find our place in the world and stand tall as the children of God. Amen.